Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. I am Magna Mega and I want to show you how I will make this new commission work. Yeah, this Judy hops. I need to recreate this model for print and 3D print. Yeah, and it will be a very great challenge to me because make any character from Disney, Pixar, DreamWorks or any that kind of movies or stuff, it's very hard to replicate. But well, it's work and I need to do it. Hope you enjoy this video, and I think I can end the face, yeah, because it's a very long process make a 3D character. But I think in this video I can show you how I made the face, yeah, right. Well, I'm setting my file. I put some reference, like some sketch about this, side of the head and front view. Yeah, I don't find the model sheet from this character, but it's not a problem. Yeah, and the first thing what I need to do is put this in editing mode, erase all the vertex. Yeah. And I put a mirror, and well, I will start making the eye. This character has a very huge eyes, and okay, oops, I will shut down this thing. I don't like it. The pivot, you can see if it's on that axis appear in there, and I don't want that. And I will draw pointing vertex. I will draw the eye something like that. That's maybe the eye shape. And let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3. Oh god, I need more cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. I need to make 2 more. And I will subdivide these. 1. And to die again. Oops. Yeah, it's important to have the same vertex or polygon in the upper lid and down here to make a nice blink when the character needs to animate it or close the eye. And this character has a very round and big eye. This. You can see I make 2 very near vertex here and same over here. Yeah. That's for the deformation of this eye later. Okay, let's see how it's look. Oops, it's appear. Okay, right now it's very flat and I need to increase this a little bit, maybe more. They're too small. Yeah, something like that. And I need to make a curve and in the top view. and I press O and move a little bit these guys like that. And I tweak a little bit this. Something like that. Let me see inside and I think the angle it's very fine. Okay. Now I move the lamp for another view. Another layer, sorry, and okay, I will add some UV sphere. I don't care so much about the polygon number of this sphere, but this will be my guide to create all the rest of the loops from the eye. Check smooth. Oops, you can see it's dark if I put it at that soon. And here we have this. Okay. Okay, this character had a very round face and I don't see too much the eye lid, but it's there. It's eyelid and eyelid is a little shorter, but it's not a problem. It's true. Oh, gotcha. I forget to put down the proportionality. Okay, this is the fierce loop polygons. And this is from making the eyelid. Yeah, this character have a very, very tiny eyelid. That way I can move it too much away from the eye. The eyeball. And this is going to separate a little bit here. And the same. That's it. You can see some strange things right here. It shakes smooth and it looks fine, but still have some distort control. And that's a flipped face. The grid of the floor, it's annoying me. I put on the render. Clean view right now, and the next one is from the eye socket, and the other socket let's go side a bit. Yeah, the first results of this model I think will look very weird, but it's part of the process, and that's very impossible to make a very nice model in the just begin, because I don't have all the reference and I will need to make a lot of tweaks. That's why it's important to use reference from a model. To avoid redo a lot of things like, I don't know, subtle details or that kind of stuff. But right now I will try to make the topology and the basic volume of the face, and later I will change and make all that little fix in the face. Now this is more part of the snout, yeah. And it's part of the eyebrow. Yeah, and any new look what I created, I try to cover more surface from the face. Yeah. Some mistake when we start making some character, it's make all the loops and too near each other, and that's look like a chameleon eye and looks very, very weird. But it's something what can fix very easy. It's only more around a little bit the eye. Okay, it's look pretty. I don't know, it's fine, but it's look decent right now. And clicking it, good to click that. Well, I made before, I don't know if you're watching before another live stream. This is not a live stream, but I made a very regular live streams about my works, and I made before Nick Wilde, yeah? And soon I will upload all the process of the model, the entire model. But in the case I need to put sound, some comments, and it's more hard to only rig the what I'm doing right now. And when I work in Nick Wilde, I don't have it a good microphone, and that's why I don't recall my voice and all that stuff. Okay, she don't have too much forehead. It's very round. All this character is very fluffy and round. It's not a very beauty body. Now we try to catch the curl of the face and all this thing, because if I catch the curves and all the rest of the polygons what I created, they have that curves, it will be more easy to work. Have a very flat side here. It's mostly okay, and another thing when I try to work, it's in this mouth, and it's very near for the eyes. Right. I think it's a great character. I like so much working in cartoon style. And I think the cartoon is have more life than other styles like realistic or even anime. I love the anime, or I love it much too much in the past, but right now I think the cartoon have all the things to the expression. That's something I can seeing in anime right now. And I don't mean that that silly expressions like a mask, like emoticons. I mean very subtle expressions and exaggerated. Like that. I mean that the eyes, the mouth. It's not very anime too, but his face have the character expression. That's why I like this kind of movies and characters. And it's what I said before, it's a very, very great challenge to model this kind of this character. I know an internet exists and really some person make a Judy Hubs, and there are have a free download version, but to my client that model don't works to print. That's why they asked me make this character, but with all that the 3D settings from 3D printer. So it's like in the middle, like that. And I need to create more loops there. So short distance in that way. Very complex to make it. It's looks so weird. But anyway, I think I go in the right direction. Here maybe I need to create more cuts here. The nose. Yeah, no, I made a triangle, but erase that right now. I hate the triangles, and all my students know. Oh, I hate that, guys. And. Now it looks like a pig. It's an animal. I it something. And it's more around. If here it's around like that. I never made this kind of face before. It's very interesting. So weird, yeah, baby. I don't care. But okay. Right now it's like square. Okay. Oh, that's it. Yeah, it looks more rabbit. Don't worry, later on we'll put some reference image in the background to make more consistent to the character. But right now it's only make some fun volume of the face. Yeah, some people maybe ask why I don't sculpt this model. And the answer, it's because I like too much make this in the old-fashioned way. I think the polygons is like a, I don't know, it's like I forget the name, pixel art and the illustration, and I think making by vertex or by polygons this model, it's like, I don't know, it's therapeutic to me. Oops, sorry. Give me some seconds. I like very much the character design of Sautopia. I love Wild and Beauty House. I think it's amazing characters. But I don't like the plot of the movie. I think they scratch only the surface of the, some problems of that kind. But anyway, it's a great movie. And I'm really, really happy to make these characters. Maybe by my... I don't know. By my own way, I never make these fun arts in this character. But how it's worked, it's important to make it. Okay. I'm trying to create all the face. And... right now, it's a base. See the view of this. So, back. To back. The heights look more high. Try to move. I can change this. Mm-hmm. Be higher, maybe a more beak, man. Or some maybe flat. Man. And that curve is very complex to make. Here in this part, I'm trying to thought. I will have the same problem with meat wires. So round without any, I don't know, landmarks in there with bones or something like that, and it's very, very huge to understand the body. Yeah, I will try to make it. Unless I can do it. Characters don't have really an atomic. It's this character has a very long process. The face, you know, that's the most complex part of the character. each round. Let's have some sharp form. Yeah, it's great. It's not so bad. Now let's still make some tweaks, but it's not a bad begin. Just more. I feel very sad. Put the mage in the background. Make some difference between these two guys. Okay. It's not that perfect. Not a perfect side, but like, can help me understand more the shape. The eye, maybe. Oops, what that? The eye is the problem. It's just a flat shape and the eye of this character are more flat. Thank you. Okay, I need to change a lot the shape of the head, and I don't know right now how make decent eye, right? I don't, but that's not the important thing right now. I'm trying to make a nice shape of the head. Can I try to separate a little bit the polygons here? I have two big vertex tool and I don't like to match that things. And I will change this a bit. See what sounds smooth. Oh god, this looks pretty bad. Here, mark to match the eye. And I need to make more smooth that transition. Okay, I still have that sharp etching in here. And I need to remove that. Maybe I will need to reorientate the topology. Okay, I still have that triangles, and I try to reshape and change a little bit the shape of the head. And here I need to clean this part. Yeah, it's too many edge in a single vertex. It's a pull vertex, and it's sometimes it's a bad idea. That's why I really try to clean that thing. Yeah. And now, try to change the flow. These little guys here. Yeah, something like that. It's more clean, but still have that triangle there. And I need to move that. That beast. Let me think something. If I cut that here, oh, that's not what I want. Maybe I need to add an extra cut in this part. Like that. I don't like yet this. The view up here is very weird. And the other sphere. Sorry if I'm so quiet, but in this case I need more concentrated than usual. That's why I shut my mouth down and but anyway, if you have any questions, you can I really like to read and answer or reply any of your questions. Yeah, feel free to ask me whatever you want in the comment box here. And of course you can find me in Facebook, Twitter and all that social media. see all and all these angles. I don't still like that. I will try to close this hole. It's not look that bad, too bad, but it looks so square, and I don't know, this model is very complex to understand because it's so fluffy around it, but this is a cute box. Here it's more clear anyway. And I will try to see more in the illustration. The eyes are very tricky, and I think it's the most complex thing about this character. And of course, the shape of the head is something very weird. I think something like that very. Okay, I think I have something more close. Yeah, she still looks very weird and angle, so that's really flat there. Okay, I think I'm more close to catch the shade of this character. I would say this is a very great challenge. These characters have a very subtle details, and that's made so hard to understand the forms. Well, to me, I don't know, maybe other guys are more have more understand how these characters are, but I have a lot of problems. I think I will try and catch it. Let's look more, I don't know, more I don't know, it's natural, but it's look more cute. It's more round, have more volume here, more flat in front. To get it yet. With more iteration of work, I think I can catch the real shapes of this character. And the expectative of this model, it's very, very high. That's why it will take me a lot of work to grab the characteristics of this pony. But part of the work, I don't have pressure to work it or rush this work. Important is take the form, this character. Okay. Now I have more clean silhouette from the this view. I will still need more work. Back of the head. Okay, this work, I think it's not perfect yet, but I think it's more close than I paint just before. I move a little bit this over here. Yeah, I think I'm really close for today. Yeah. Yeah, this is not a easy work, you know? The 3D in general, it's not or move some fancy tools and make something great. Now these things take some hours, maybe days, to create something awesome. Of course, some people in only a few hours make a great things. But not normal. That people can make something great in only a few hours, that's because they have a lot of of work done and a lot of practice experience, and that's becoming something more speed to work, but that's a lot of effort and hard work, and it's not easy. It's not something what I gain in a few hours or making some I don't know, 5 models or like something like that. Not something you gain with a lot of effort. Yeah, I don't say if you can do it in a few hours, yeah, but if you can do it, that's because you have a lot of information in your mind and a lot of experience and a lot of things. Maybe you are a great sculptor with real clay, or you are an awesome illustrator, yeah, and you know about anatomy and all that stuff, and put that in only in a 3D program. That's more, it's not easy, but that's why maybe that people can create very awesome things in very few hours. Now, to me, that takes me more than a few hours, maybe some days or even weeks. Maybe I am more slowpoke to work, but no problem. All the people have different rhymes and speeds, and it's important to understand or to know Anyway, I think it's done from today. I still need to work on the top of the head, but right now I don't think I will get much that I do right now, and maybe have some time of relax and not see this project. Brings me more idea from how make that part. Well, hope you enjoy this video, and please, how I say before, ask me whatever you want about this project or any other videos or commissions or whatever you want. Yeah, you can support my work in my Patreon page. Yeah, I have Patreon, and there I will share different things. Yeah, like exclusive content of my sketchbooks or exclusive 3D models. Yeah, and well, a lot of I think it's very interesting stuff, and please check it out. And any dollar or any support, I will appreciate it so much. Thank you for seeing this video, and I see you in the next time. Bye bye.